Award-winning biographer Lyndall Gordon is joining me in studio to talk about her incredibly moving memoir, Divided Lives. Thank you so much for sitting down with us.
It's a pleasure.
Now, why don't you introduce me to Divided Lives? Why did you decide to write this book now?
Well, now is simply because I put it off and put it off. From earliest childhood here in Cape Town, I was a sort of child carer companion to my invalidish mother, mm-hmm. who was a poet, an unpublished poet, and I always felt I had to be a channel for her life and writing. Yeah. But when I put it off because as I grew older, I became more and more feminist. I was part of second wave feminism. I was then a student in New York in 1970 mm-hmm. and very bound up with that movement. And that was part of the divide from my mother, who became increasingly religious, and I didn't go that way.
Yeah.
But after she died in 1999, I did feel the time had come to write about her and her aspirations and her dreams. And when I came to write a proposal for Virago, you know, which is a woman's press mm-hmm. in London, my editor very much wanted it to be a mother and daughter memoir, not just a memoir of my mother. Yeah. So rather reluctantly, reluctant in the sense that I'm quite shy. I didn't really want to write a lot about myself, but having the editor I did, I do hear what she's saying, and she was very persuasive, and I found myself writing more about myself than I'd intended.
Well, editors are always very persuasive, aren't
very.
They?
Well, she was stimulating. Mm-hmm. She wasn't, it didn't feel like I was being forced. She was suggesting this could be a terrific book if you do what I'm suggesting to you. Mm-hmm. And then I tried to do it, and then she wanted me to do more. I thought all the time of, in my own mind, the dreaded chapter 13, which I called The Way Down, which was about my own illness. I was susceptible to the hormonal changes of pregnancy, mm-hmm. and I had a very severe postpartum depression. So in some way, it was a book about a mother's daughter to an ill mother, a daughter's duty to an ill mother.
Yeah.
And it became a question of a mother's duty to an ill daughter as well. But there was no straight, simple story in both cases. It was a very mixed story. My editor called it a layered book because I felt, although I was very anxious about my mother being ill when I was a child, and it was a secret, her illness was never mentioned, it was mm-hmm. like one of those family secrets that families keep to themselves. My mother appeared normal in public when she did pull herself together to go out.
Mm-hmm.
But so I was anxious about her, and I pitied her because she had for fainting attacks. I didn't immediately say what the illness was because she herself didn't know what was the matter, and she feared it was mental illness.
Mm-hmm. Well, we don't learn what the illness is for but five chapters.
That's it, exactly, yeah. Five chapters. I felt I wanted the reader to experience what it's like to live with quite a severe illness, a chronic lifelong illness, and not to know what exactly it is. And my mother, at a certain point in her 30s, demanded to know. But it took her, she'd been ill since she was 17. Mm-hmm. So it was many years of mm-hmm. darkness for her. At the same time, I wanted very much to bring out what an exciting person she was, because she was a dreamer who was an intense reader. And she read broadly mm-hmm. poetry, the great classics, particularly Wordsworth and Emily Bronte, mm-hmm. Emily Dickinson. She loved the visionary writers. She loved Catherine Mansfield's New Zealand stories, and she would read them to us. But she was particularly good with children, and she read The Water Babies, and she read aloud at night to her children, and also to me when I was alone with her in the day, because I didn't mm-hmm. go to school right away. I would say, Jennifer, an alternative education.
Mm-hmm.
And I felt now, in retrospect, that whatever has been important to me in my life, that is writing, seeing characters all important for biography and memoir, that comes from my mother. Yeah. And it was a bigger gift than formal education, this reading that was going on at home, which was actually shared reading. Mm-hmm. And when I did my proposal for the book, and it was so focused on my mother, I didn't think of the subject of shared reading. It was something, when you write memoir, memories come up as you write. Mm-hmm. It's as though your memory becomes heightened,
yeah,
if you concentrate. And one of the things I hadn't thought of writing about but came to me only as I was writing was that my mother worked even when she was very ill, during the Second World War and afterwards, she worked for the Cape Jewish Orphanage as a librarian. Mm-hmm. And she went twice a week and I went with her. I found that I had very clear memories of how she related to the orphans. It was full to capacity,
yeah,
during the Second World War. And she really elicited from children what they liked to read.